world. There's just so many great and awesome things that God has spoken about you. So come on, live with intention, compassion, kindness, and generosity. Embrace and accept yourself with grace and love. Be grateful for you. That's right. Be grateful for you and all you hold near and dear, or should hold near and dear. There's so many things going on around you. There's so many blessings attached to you that you can't see it because you're looking around. But just begin to look. Begin to show gratitude. Wake up each morning. Look at yourself in the mirror and smile. You are not alone. You truly are loved. Amen. 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 That was a little poem. It was written by a young man. Amen. And I posted it on my Facebook page at Evangelist Val Robinson. Evangelist Val Truly Blessed Robinson. Look me up there and you'll see that post in his name. We give credit to where credit is due. Amen. Amen. We love you. We encourage you on today. Stop looking at them. Begin to be you. Do the things that God has created you to do, and don't worry about the rest, because if you just do what he has created, predestined, preordained for you to do, oh my God, the things, the awesome things, the life that will be changed. Gosh, if I had time, I will take the time. Amen. I think we still got a little time on here. Amen. Yes, we do. Let me tell you a little brief testimony, because I was at this church and I was just sitting there, and there was a young lady, amen, that the Lord put me in her eyesight, amen. And months later, after meeting her and beginning to be a part of her life, you know, praying for her and being there for her when she needs me, whenever she desires to call, or however God lays it on her heart, whatever he lays it on her heart for her to do. Well, she bare witness to me something, a thought that she had. And she said, you know what, when I saw you sitting there, she says, I didn't see anything. I didn't see any gifts. I didn't see any talent. I didn't see anything. I just saw a lady, an older lady sitting there in the church that day. She said, and my, was I ever wrong? She says, because God has shown me, she says, you got so many talents. She said, because then I didn't know that you could cook the way you can cook. I didn't know you can sew. I didn't know that you can pray like you can pray. She says, now, when I heard you pray, I was like, oh, my God, because it touched me. And so it caused change. Amen. But the thing about it is, it wasn't for that reason. It wasn't just to show her who he said I was, because later on, she was at a restaurant God had told her to go to. Amen. She said, I didn't want to go, but God took me there that day. And there was a lady there, and this lady was just overwhelmed. I mean, she was burdened down. And the lady shared that she was having these issues. And she said, well, I have a friend you need to talk to. I need to let you talk to Evangelist Val. Amen. Amen. And hallelujah. God will set you up. Amen. Because here she was again. She didn't see anything. She didn't see gifts, talents, anything. She didn't see the anointing. Amen. She just saw this person sitting there. Amen. But didn't know how God was going to connect her and I, and the works that he was going to do through us together. Amen. Because see, there's a plan and a purpose. Everything, there's a time and a season. There's a reason for God putting you, getting you to a place where he can begin to use you. Amen. In the lives of others. So she's sitting there and she tells this lady, I need you to talk to Evangelist Val. I just need her to pray with you. I need her to pray for you. Amen. So they called me on the phone, and of course I was available. Thank God for availability. Amen. Sometimes we can be too busy, but anyway, going along. Turns out I began to pray, and I began to tell this lady what I hear God saying. Amen. Amen. Didn't know her from Adam or Eve. Didn't know her from anybody else. I never met her. Didn't know. This woman didn't tell me anything about her. So it was all God. Amen. And that's how he works. Because he don't want people to have no doubt that it's him, that it is not me speaking, not her speaking. Amen. So God began to speak to this woman and her situation and her circumstances. And he begins to tell her things through me. Amen. To not only encourage her, but to bring her out of that place that she was in, unknown to me of the other woman, the extent of how vital and important it was that she and I meet, that we come together, amen, we form a bond, amen, and then we cause change to happen in this person's life. Because when it was all said and done, the woman was so thankful. She thanked both of us and for the connection and for the prayer, and she went on her way. But before she left, the young lady, amen, who was again at a restaurant, she showed her a 45. Amen. This woman was so distraught. This woman was so at the end of her row that she had a loaded 45 in her purse. And when she left her job that day, her intentions was to go home and blow her brains out. Amen. So let me tell you something about you. That's why I'm saying, you don't ever know. Quit trying to be like everybody else. Quit trying to do the thing that everybody else is doing. Just do you. Just go where he said go. Just say what he said say. Just make the connections with the people that he wants you to connect to. Quit trying to get with them and be with him. Amen. Be the person God needs you to be. Be satisfied in that, because you don't know how he's going to use you to save a life. Amen. You don't know when it's your turn. Amen. To be that gap. To stand in the middle, amen, to cause life and not death, amen. She had no idea that day that God was going to do that. All she knew is she had to obey God. Then she had to reach back, get the person that she didn't see the gifts or the talents or the anointing on, amen, to save that life. So see, God can use who he desires. And I truly believe this morning that there's someone that will hear this message that God's been trying to get your attention, but you're so engrossed, you're so emotional, you so want to be like them, amen, but all you need to do is stand still and listen. Listen to his small voice as it began to speak to you on today, as it began to lead you on today to that place where he can use your life. Amen. It's great that they're doing so many wonderful things, that they've got number one hits on the chart, that they've got followers here and there going places that you might desire to go, but stand still. See the salvation of the Lord on today. Be you. Be the you that he has created you to be. It will make a difference. Somebody's life is hanging in the balance this morning. Amen. Don't be so busy trying to run after your own way that you forget his. Amen. I encourage you on today. Be you. Be you. Be thankful. Be grateful. I don't care what it looks like right now, because you never know. You never know. It's like people who were poor, who were homeless, who just went in the store and they bought, and I'm like, yes, I'm going to use the world tactic. They went and they bought one lottery ticket, and they became millionaires, and they didn't have to eat out of the garbage can anymore. They didn't sleep in cardboard boxes. God, he's able, if the world is able to bless people like that, what about the God, the great and awesome God that we serve? Are you telling me he's limited by your thoughts of who you are and who you would choose, who you would rather choose to be? Oh my God. God, he's such an awesome God, and he wants to do such awesome things through you. Be you. Be you. I encourage you on this morning. Wait upon the Lord, for they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength, shall mount up as wings of an eagle. Amen. Amen. You know the scripture. You know the word of God. Stand still. Wait on him. Be who he has chosen you to be. Your eyes have not seen, your ears have not heard, heard rather the things that God has spoken about you, that God has predestined, preordained for you to do. Just be you. Hallelujah. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come now. God, as we prepare to leave this place, oh God, to leave this place. God, never allow us to leave your presence, oh God. God, we ask that you would just look upon those that are hearing this message this morning, and you begin to speak to their hearts and their minds, their souls, oh God. You will begin to speak to them, God, and you will begin to manifest yourself in their will, oh God. Not our will, but your will be done in their lives, oh God. Begin to speak to them, oh God. Begin to allow them to know who you say that they are, who you have chosen them to be. God, begin to open up their eyes that they may see, and their ears that they may hear and understand. They'll be able to receive the wisdom from your word. Draw them closer to you, oh God, that they will begin to walk in your way. That they begin to do the things that you have chosen for them to do. God, we bless you on today. God, I ask that you will begin to heal their emotions. God, begin to just walk them through their fiery furnaces, oh God, on today. Have your way in their lives like never before, oh God. And use them mightily. Allow them to be who you have chosen them to be. Not some carbon copy, not some phony person that they change every time you see them. It just depends on who they're around, and you look and you wonder, who is this person? Because this is not the person I deal with daily. Father, strip them of inhumility and give them humility, oh God, that they may become the chosen people, the chosen ones, the one who's going to make a true difference in the lives of those who are yet to believe, oh God. Father, we thank you today. We thank you for this media. We thank you for this opportunity to come and to share. What does you say? God, make us not just hearers of the word, but doers. Just allow our purpose to be a chosen vessel to do your will. In Jesus' name I pray. And I thank you in advance for all the great and mighty works, the greater works that they're going to do, oh God. It's not that they're going to truly do greater works than thee, because you are the greatest, most awesome being. But God, they're going to do things that have the same magnitude, oh God, that has the same abilities, oh God. They're going to be able to make lives begin to walk out their purposes, oh God, because of their obedience to you. So, Father, we thank you, and we humbly ask all these things in the mighty name of your Son, Jesus, that sweet Jesus, the one who came, he hung, he bled, he died on Calvary's cross, giving us the right. Father, we thank you. Amen. Amen. Again, we thank God for you being here, for you listening in. God bless you. God keep you always. Until the next time, again, this has been Let's Talk About It. I'm Evangelist Val Robinson. Again, coming to you live from the beautiful city of Hattiesburg, Mississippi. I tell you, God is so awesome. Didn't have to leave my house. Didn't have to go through a whole lot of things to get this word out, to get this message to you this morning, because you are important to him. Don't you forget that. Amen. And so, come on, love on yourself. Love him and begin to do the great and awesome things that he has already assigned your life to do. Be the you that he has caused you to be. He's called you to be great. Again, God bless you. God keep you. Until the next time, have a wonderful, wonderful day. Amen.